So you got some Mac cleaner adware going on, giving you pop-ups and wanting you to pay for stuff. Or you got some of that web browser malware that's hijacking your web browsing and taking you to places you don't want to go. Yuck. I'll show you how to get rid of it and keep it off using one of my favorite cleaning apps. So this video is for you if you just want the malware gone. It might look like this. You might have little new things in your menu bar, you know. This is more adware, but it's a Mac cleaner type thing. Maybe if you go to a web browser, you're getting these weird search pages and home pages like, you know, Mac boosters, Mac cleaners, things like that. You might see a search engine that sort of looks like Google, but isn't Google. I'm going to show you how to get rid of this in six easy steps. This is a tried and true method that all of our consultants have used for years and years, and we do it all the time. My favorite app is Malwarebytes. The website is malwarebytes.com. If in the future I recommend something different or Malwarebytes is not around anymore, just check the description of this video for my recommended replacement. But just go to malwarebytes.com and click on free download. It'll download automatically for you. Once it's downloaded, you can go to your downloads and open it up from here to install it. And then just say yes, continue, agree. Just type the password for your Mac. So this is the one you type whenever you restart your computer. Once it installs, it will launch automatically on your Mac, and you can say installing on the personal computer. They're going to recommend the premium version of Malwarebytes, which I recommend if you get malware reasonably often. But I would go ahead and say not now is totally fine. You will get a full scan and a complete scan by not doing the premium version. Just click scan now and go ahead and do that. And it's basically just checking the files on your computer against what Malwarebytes knows about or the viruses and malware that they know about in their database. So if something brand new has come out, it may not catch it, but usually they're pretty quick. And I just recommend doing whatever they say. So when it says found threats, I just say, great, remove it, confirm. And so it does that. It usually recommends that you restart your Mac. And I would say restart. You can do it right away. I'm going to say not now for the purposes of this video. Now the Mac Keeper thing is saying that it wants to uninstall, so you can say yes to that and type your Mac password. They often ask you for feedback, why are you leaving, blah blah blah. Close the window, ignore that, you don't need to answer that. Now this is usually a quicker check if Malwarebytes has already done its scan, but I always go into the applications folder and check for apps that have been added recently. So if you go to applications and then go to the view menu and sort by date added, the keyboard command for that is a Vulcan death grip command control option 4, but it's cool to know anyway. Things that have been installed recently are, they pop up to the top here. So if you see any other cleaner apps, things like that, you can just click on it and then press command delete on the keyboard to delete it. Go ahead and type your Mac password if you do that. I also check under the menus in the top right to make sure that it's only the things I recognize. Once in a while, Malwarebytes won't remove something out of system preferences that you need to remove. So go to system preferences. You can also get there from Apple menu, system preferences. And especially look for profiles, something called profiles. You can do a search for it up here as well if you don't immediately see it. But you can look for that. Often there's something in here, creepy bullshit, for example, and just go ahead and remove it. Hit the little minus button to remove that and remove it. It's rare that you need something in profiles. It might be if you are in a school or in a managed office, they might have profiles installed for you, so you can just ask your IT person about that. Then just type your Mac password to remove that, and it gets it out of there. I always check startup items as well. So if you go into users and groups, and then go into login items, just make sure there's nothing in here that looks suspicious. I do have Mac Keeper here, so I'm gonna remove that. And these guys I use Dropbox and I use Zoom, so those are fine. But those are the two things that you do need to check in system preferences. Malwarebytes will remove the malware, but normally you need to clean up your browsers. Usually the homepage and the search page need to be fixed. And also sometimes they'll have an extension or an add-on that needs to be removed. So I'll start with Safari. Just go into Safari, go to the Safari menu and go to Preferences. And you can see the homepage is some sort of weird search, so you can just change that to google.com. If you go into the search section here, the search engine is Bing, you can, or whatever else it is, you can change that to Google. And I always check under extensions as well and just remove anything that's here that you don't recognize. Same thing for Chrome. You just open up Chrome and then go to the Chrome menu and go to Preferences. And you can change and fix the search engine on the left and change it from whatever it is to whatever you want it to be. You'll also notice here where it says on startup, sometimes it'll say open a specific page or set of pages. And if there's something here that you don't recognize, just hit the three little dots and say remove. And then it'll automatically choose open the new tab page. And then in Chrome, you just hit the tiny little three dots in the top right here. Go to more tools, go to extensions. And just make sure there's nothing in here that seems suspicious. Just remove and delete anything you don't recognize from in here. It's better to have it lean and clean. And lastly, if you go into Firefox, same thing. You just go to the Firefox menu and then Preferences. And on the left, you go to Search, and you can change the search engine back to Google. And then go to Home, and you can change the homepage to whatever you want it to be. And in Firefox, to get to the add-ons, you just go to the Tools menu up here and go to Add-ons. And just anything that you don't recognize in here, just disable it, hit the three little dots and say never activate. And that's the equivalent in Firefox. I always want to test and make sure that the malware is gone and then uninstall any apps that are going to be running in the background. So I like to do one last scan with Malwarebytes and then uninstall it. So you say scan now. And again, if you want to keep it, you can do that. You can pay, or you can just keep it installed on your Mac and do the free scan once in a while. I personally, on my Mac, prefer to not have things running in the background and just do it when I need it. It says, congratulations, you're clean. Fantastic. So then you just go up to the help menu and uninstall Malwarebytes. Yes, you want to proceed, and then you type your Mac password. And then I also test all of the browsers to make sure that the homepage looks normal and that the searches all work normally as well. And lastly, I would restart the Mac one more time and just keep an eye out for any more flare-ups. Malware usually comes from less reputable websites. Trashy news sites, pirated or streaming video sites, porn sites, so avoid those. But if you must go to those, then just watch out for any pop-ups that look like they're from Apple tech support that say that you've got viruses and you need to call a phone number. They just want your money. Ignore any pop-ups that say you need to install some video player like Flash or things like that. If you actually want to check if you have Flash, then go to the actual adobe.com website and choose your country and then do a search on that page for the actual thing that you're looking for. That way you can be sure that you're on the actual reputable website. So you could go there. If something says you need to contact Apple tech support, then go to the Apple website and go to their support page from here. And that way you know for sure that if you're contacting Apple tech support, it's actually them.
If you find that it keeps coming back and you're not sure why, just head to Macinhome.com. Get in touch, we will help.
If you want professional one-on-one help with the tips in this video or with anything else in your Mac lifestyle, head to Macinhome.com to schedule a consult. Okay.